Hi guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. So in this video, I will be showing you how to find unlimited e-commerce leads. So if you are someone who is providing services to e-commerce stores or e-commerce businesses, this video is for you. In this video, I will show you how to find a list of URLs on which all e-commerce stores are built on. So as you are familiar with multiple platforms which e-commerce businesses use to build their platform on, like Shopify, BigCommerce, WooCommerce, Wix, and there are more than like 210 plus platforms which e-commerce brands are using currently to build out their store. So I'll show you a way to how to find the list of all these websites built on particular platform. Then I'll show you how to scrap all those websites in one go, and then how to take those list of website URLs and get decision maker in all those companies using Apollo, and how to segment those lists as well to better personalize your emails as well. So as I always emphasize on finding qualified leads rather than just leads, in this video as well, I will teach you how to create buckets of leads. It's just not about just finding all those e-commerce stores built on Shopify, BigCommerce, WooCommerce, and everywhere, right? It's also about better segmenting your list to better personalize your emails so you can have better conversions from less emails, right? So let's jump over to my screen. I'll walk you through step by step of scraping those URLs, getting the leads from those URLs, and creating a verified list of decision makers. So my name is Saurabh and I'm the founder of Scoutreach, a B2B marketing agency where we are helping more than 20 plus clients to get more sales calls on a performance basis. So let's jump over to my screen and I'll show you how we find unlimited e-commerce leads at Scoutreach. So the first step is finding the right list of URLs. So we will be using myip.ms. We will scrap this website. So this is a paid website, but I'll show you a way how you can scrap this website for free and how you can use those URLs as well. So on this website, we can find a list of URLs of e-commerce stores which are built on a particular technology. So let's say we want to target Shopify stores. We can find data of all the companies built on Shopify. We can find data of all the companies built on WooCommerce, BigCommerce, all these platforms, right? So in this video, I will show you one method to do it, and you can use the similar method to scrape the website URLs for all the platforms you can find on this website, right? So let's start with it. So first of all, what you're going to do is go to hosting companies and click US. Then you will be redirected to this page. And on this page, you can find all these website hosting companies on which X number of websites are built. So you can see on Microsoft, there are 136,000 websites, and you can also scrape all these websites with this method, right? So I'm going to select all records. So on the 34th row, I have BigCommerce, which have more than 25,000 websites. So I'll click on it. So after clicking on it, I will be redirected to this page, which has all these, you know, pages with all the website URLs, right? So you see there are 50 websites on the first page. And if I click on this, I'll be redirected to the next 50. Also, I have tried using Instant Data Scraper to scrap this all the data, but it hasn't worked for me. Also, it will block your IP if you start scraping like 10, 20, 100 pages from this website. So to avoid that issue, I have a solution for you. So let me show you how it works. First of all, we will be getting the list of all these pages one by one URLs, right? So if I go to this first page, and this is the URL I can come up with, right? So now I'm going to be making a Google sheet to show you how to do the further step, right? So now I have made the BigCommerce Google sheet. So now what I want you to do it, copy the URL from this page, this URL, and paste it here, right? So if you analyze this URL, you see this is the first page of BigCommerce database, right? So if I type second here, I will be redirected to the second page of this database. So let me show you how it works. So you see, we have the second page here. Now, if I do similarly for all these pages till 503, I will have all the URLs, which have all 50 URLs on each page. So 50 into 500, it's like 25,000, right? So now your next task is to get all these website URLs one by one till 503. So to speed up that process, I'm going to show you a way to do it. So we will be separating these URLs into three parts. So first is the part before the number. Then I'm going to type numbers as well. Now we will add the remaining part. So now we will do this for all the 503 pages, right? So let me show you how to do it. So if I select all these four and start doing this, it will quickly number it three till, let's say 504, right? So we actually need it till 503, right? So I'll have all these pages. So to get all these part together, you will be applying a formula in Google Sheet, which will be, so you can just quickly copy this, like first, second, third, and close. So if you do this, you have all these URLs, right? Now, if you copy one of these URLs and check which page you are redirected to, you will be redirected to that particular page. So let's say if I want to check 485th page, I'll copy this URL. I'm pasting this in my other browser. And you see, I am redirected to 485th page. Now you see, we have all the valid list of URLs, which you can use to scrap all those 50 listings on each page one by one. Now I'm going to show you a way to automate the steps to scrap all these pages in one go. And for that, we will be using a software which is called Octoparse. So let me log into Octoparse and I'll get back to you. So this is how Octoparse looks like, right? So now I only have the free version for you, but I'm going to show you how to do it in this. But I'm again telling you, don't use the free version. Just opt for the paid version if you want to scrap this. So first of all, what you are going to do is click on new and create a custom task. And you will be entering all these URLs manually. So what now you have to do is select all these 503 URLs you just created and paste all these here. Now you see I have all these URLs here with the right metrics. So you are going to then click save and Octoparse will start loading the first page. So you can only create, or you only want to create custom crawlers on Octoparse if all the pages are same, you just want different data from that. Like you want same elements from all these pages. So I have like 503 pages here for you, right? And I want same table from all these 503 pages. So Octoparse will make the job easy for me and scrape all those data for me in one go. So as you can see, it has automatically detected the data it has found on their page. So you see, we have all this website here with all these URLs, website URLs. We have 50 URLs on the first page, as you already know. It has given me all these IP addresses, website IP address, you know, everything it can find on. You can also create your own workflow if you want any different data from here, but this is what I want from this, right? Now, this works for us. We want Octoparse to go on every page to scrap this particular data, right? This works for us. So you are going to what do is save this. You can click run after you have identified the right metrics to scrap from these pages. So you see, now see there are two options to crawl this data. First is run on your device, which is free. So second is the paid version. So second is running in the cloud, which also auto rotates IP while getting all this data. So your IP doesn't get blocked and it can pretty much do it in half an hour, like scrape all these 500 pages in half an hour. Also, if you are going to do it on your device, it will take forever. And also you won't be able to do it in the first place because myip.ms will block your IP, right? So you will be running in the cloud version. You can use standard mode or boost mode and it will start running all these scraps and give you a list at the end of your scrap. Like it will scrap 50 listings from 503 pages and you will have all these websites. So you can also do it for Shopify, which has like millions of stores on myip.ms, and you get a data of like millions of stores for targeting, right? Now I have shown you how to get the list of data of particular platform, how to scrap those URLs. Now I'm going to show you how to take those URLs and get the data of decision makers in those brands or those companies, right? And how you can better segment those leads as well, right? So to do that, we will be using apollo.io. And before that, you need to download the CSV file from Octoparse. And then I'll show you how to use that list of URLs to find the data. So this is how the file from Octoparse would look like. I have imported that file. So I have now around 450 URLs of companies built on BigCommerce, right? So now I just need the URLs. So all these are mostly irrelevant. So we can delete these columns. So now I'll use Apollo to further find the data, right? So this is how Apollo looks like. So I will be going to People's tab. I will copy all these 450 URLs. I'll go to the Companies tab and include this into the list of companies I want to see. So instead of people, I'll try companies and see how many of these companies Apollo can detect. So I see there are 272 companies Apollo is able to detect from this list of 450 URLs. So if you give it like 20,000 website URLs, it will be most probably able to give you like 10,000, 12,000 valid companies, and that's a good data set for you. Now from these 272 companies, we need the data, right? So what you're gonna do is click on people and you see you have 559 contacts of these companies. Now you can further filter them down based on the industry as well. So you can target apparel brands if you want, right? So in Apollo, there are 272 companies, right? Now to further filter down this list, you can use Apollo's filter to do that. So from myip.ms, we want the whole database, which isn't segmented, right? Then we can use Apollo to segment the data into small buckets. So you can use that as a personalization point as well, right? So how you're gonna do it? Either you can use keywords or you can use the industry filters. So let's try using the keywords feature. So let's say we want to go after beauty brands in US and there are 200 companies in US, and with industries, I'll go to keywords. I'll make sure I have all this ticked in. So now I have like 22 companies. So obviously I have a lot smaller data set. So if I had like 20,000 companies, I would be getting like 2,000 companies for this. And again, 2,000 to 3,000 qualified lead as well, right? So after this, you're going to click on People's tab and you'll see there are 178 leads for these companies. Now you can go ahead and start saving those leads. That's how you go from a list of URLs on myip.ms to a list of a decision maker in these companies. So similarly, you can scrap all these websites on amazon.com, Cloudflare, Google, Shopify. So you just have to click this page and you have like this URL. Again, you are going to work on this URL to separate these elements and make a list of URLs that goes until 12,407 pages. Put that into Octoparse and get all the data and use Apollo to find the data of decision maker in these companies, right? So that's all for this video, guys. So I hope you get how you can first of all find the targeted list of URLs of e-commerce stores built on a particular technology, how to scrap those URLs in one go without blacklisting your IP on scale, and how to take those URLs, use Apollo to find the data of decision makers. Also make sure after you get those leads from Apollo, you verify all those leads before sending out those emails. So if you have any particular questions or video ideas for me in relation to this video or organic appointment setting, feel free to comment below this video. I hope you liked it. I hope it helps in your lead generation journey. I hope it helps in booking you more and more appointments with your ideal clients. And I'll see you in the next one. Also, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thanks. Cheers.